Well, I'm going to tell you what exactly happened, how £1,000 was stolen from this car.
Check out our sponsors, Nature's Blends. They specialize in premium Ethiopian black seed products. The website is in the description link below. You can also use the discount code SALAM10 for 10% off their products.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters and dear friends. What's that noise behind me? It sounds like a Ferrari. Well, that's what many people think when I'm driving down the road and they hear this. Well, I'm going to tell you what exactly happened, how £1,000 was stolen from this car. But before I do that, I just want to let you guys know, this car is not owned by me. It's a Prius, beautiful car, I'm going to talk about it. But it's owned by this rental company. So this rental company, brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, have helped me with this car. But let's go inside. Let me tell you the story. Follow me.
Time to turn it off. Get in the car. Let's talk about this now. Now, guys, let me tell you guys what happened. Oh, one second. There we go. Let's get the wife in there. Those fumes. So, guys, this is what happened. Before I come to this, what happened, let me just tell you a bit about this car, yeah? Because you see, I've driven a lot of cars in my life, yeah? Different cars, alhamdulillah. I drive the C-Class, I drive the E-Class, I drive the GLE. I've driven many cars that I didn't personally own myself. However, one thing that I found very similarities between this car and that car, and I'm going to tell you why I'm mentioning this, and we're going to come to the £1,000, yeah? Is, alhamdulillah, when you get into the car, for example, you don't need to unlock it. You just put your hand. And the E-Class had that very same feature. It's got rear view camera. The E-Class had that feature. And let me be honest, with the E-Class, when I was going over bumps, it was quite rough. With this, it's actually quite smooth. It takes me from A to B. I do my shopping, and me and my family don't have to be standing out in the rain, in the cold, etc. And alhamdulillah, it provides for me. I make a living, a halal income, instead of going and doing drugs or killing people to earn a haram income. And this is what we're going to come to about the income matter, yeah? Now, let's put that to a side. That wasn't the reason I was doing this video. The reason I'm mentioning that is, guys, because I'm a YouTuber, I'm an influencer. A lot of people think I drive a lavish cars, etc. I live a lavish lifestyle. Not really, alhamdulillah. If I have the means, there's nothing wrong with that. Don't get it twisted. If I have the means, I will buy myself a nice car. Don't worry about that. Anyways, but the point behind that is, brothers and sisters, be proud. I don't hide myself when people are going like, oh my gosh, they're going to see Ali Dawah in the Prius. Alhamdulillah, this was jahiliya. I used to think like, oh, I don't want people to think, brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, we are happy and you should be happy and proud. Get rid of this mentality of enslavement. Now, anyways, let's get to the crux of the matter.
Yeah. So basically, what happened, brothers and sisters, a couple of days ago, I came to my car and the car sounded just how you guys heard it. And I was thinking, like, I thought, well, did the engine blow up or something, yeah? That wasn't the case. So what it was, I thought, okay, you know, there's some kind of a hole in the exhaust pipe. And then I rang the mechanics and they said to me, it might be the case that actually your car, they've stolen your catalytic converter. Yes, that's what it's called. And I thought, okay, not big deal, probably like £1,500. And he goes to me, no, it's actually £1,000. I was at what, one with three zeros at the end, fam. He's like, yeah. So I was like thinking, oh man, £1,000 worth, because it has some kind of chrome in it. So brothers and sisters, the reason I'm doing this video is to talk about risk, yeah? People's income. Now, you can be a thief. This can be a video to those who might be thieves, yeah? For those who earn a halal income. You earn a halal income, you don't, you're a thief, whatever right you take from somebody else, you need to understand something. Do not ever think you have gained something extra. You've gained nothing extra, except you've gained sins. Let me tell you how. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to us that in the Quran, if I'm mistaken, that the birds, he feeds the birds. They go out from their nest for their rizq and they come back with their tummies full. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a creation of millions and trillions and billions, even microorganisms in our body that eat on different things. So brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides for everyone, except those who are starving to death. And that's because of our stinginess and us not giving in donations and etc. And even that we blame to God. Oh God, why is that? Yeah, etc. Anyways, the point behind this is, brothers and sisters, is that when somebody steals something off you, brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written your risk. That thief didn't gain £1,000 from me. He didn't. He took something which was going to come to him in a halal way, but he earned it in a haram way. So that £1,000 or whatever it may be was going to come to him, but he chose to seek it in a haram way, and he didn't gain anything extra. And this is profound. He didn't gain £1,000 extra. All he gained was the sins behind that. And I ask Allah to forgive him, and I ask Allah to guide him to Islam. Genuinely, I ask that, yeah? Monetary things are not, they don't really faze me. Money, etc., let that be gone, rather than my health or my iman. As long as these two are handled in check, and even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometimes will test you with the iman or the health. But my point is this, brothers and sisters, when you're earning a halal income, when I work sometimes and I do Uber, shaitan comes to me. It's asr time. Oof, I need to pray asr. Well, hold on a second. A job just came. Two times surcharge. Woo, you know what that means? I make double the money. Shaitan comes, you know what? You can come pray later. Hold on a second. Let's suppose I take that risk and I miss my salah. My salah is gone. Did I earn anything extra? No. That was written for me. So why would I risk losing my salah over something, an income that Allah's already written for me? Shaitan is an enemy. That's why Allah says in the Quran, take him as an enemy. So brothers and sisters, my reminder for this video in a nutshell was that, is the following, that do not think that you're going to earn something extra by taking from someone or being jealous of someone because of their success. Wallahi, all you're doing is taking away from your mental well-being, and all you're doing is incurring sins. That was my reminder, inshallah, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and make us firm to have tawakkul in Him, to inshallah trust Him with whatever we provided and don't go to means of haram. Till next time, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. From the Prius Ferrari, goodbye.